said, let's get this shit started.
Yeah, I don't know how good I'm going to be on this one.
Let's do this.
In 3, 2, 1. I told your mom that I had to go to the band. She told me to close the door. She posted up, sitting on the stool, scrolling through my phone. Sometimes I get lost in the noise from the peaceful bathroom pain. I'll be missing for hours, but I'm just here on the kit. Every time I sit down, my legs fall asleep. I'll just be yanking and yanking new sheets. I'll be using up all the TP we own. Double flushing, hoping and praying it's gone. Who clogged the toilet? Wasn't me who left the TP unloaded. Wasn't me who left the plunger soaking. Wasn't me who left this thing floating. Wasn't me. Yeah.
That's a song right there.
It wasn't me. That's a good way to start this shit.
Sure.
What's up, muggos?
I don't know, man. I've given up on humanity and people, and I think people need to start feeling the wrath of me, to be honest.
Well, it seems that you're too nice now. So yeah. Maybe go the other way. Maybe just be a dick. Yeah. It seems like people who are dicks live life fine.
Yeah. They do, man. First of all, they don't give a fuck what people think, which is great. And they don't let people walk on them. Walk all over them.
Yeah, sure, some people hate them and, you know, they're terrible people, but they seem to be living fine. So maybe it's time for revenge mugs. Like, just be an asshole. Don't give a fuck.
Does that mean, start unfollowing people, or is that, like, petty shit?
Fucking be petty. Be Petty LaBelle, man. Fucking do it. Be a Petty Pemblet.
Petty Pemblet, yeah.
Come on, just fucking baddie. Go for it.
I think I am, man, because, like, people need to...
Do it right now. Just unfollow whoever's fucking bothering you right now. Gives a fuck.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah? Yeah. Hold on, I'm going to check if you still follow me. Just do it, man.
That doesn't seem like, fuck, like, I don't know, I think if I do that, I think that's going to vindicate more than it's going to, you know what I mean? I think so.
Hold on. Let me.
This person will notice if I unfollow him, for sure.
Let me rewind here. Someone's bothering you, right?
Couple people are actually.
Okay. If you do be petty and start unfollowing and do this shit, you know what's going to happen? It's going to open a discussion, a dialogue. And then now it's going to be like, oh, now you want to fucking talk to me, huh?
Yeah.
Right? And if they don't, then fucking whatever. Then that means they didn't care. And then that's going to hurt you even more, though.
No, actually, honestly, like, my hope is to have them unfollow me, to be honest, if I do that.
Well, then just fucking unfollow them, block them, do whatever.
I don't know, man. I think, like...
I'm being a bitch. Do you do it? Do it right now.
Yeah. I don't know, man. As much as I want to, I don't know if that's going to prove anything. And I think I just do it low-key. I think I just stop looking at their shit and liking their shit. And
well, you're not, because you're going to do it because that's what you do. So either block them, mute them, or just unfollow them. Fuck it, mugs. Come on, dude. Do it.
Yeah.
Or just get off of social media altogether.
I kind of need it for my job, but I don't know, man. I think
I mean, you need it. You could post about it, but you don't have to watch it. Do your business. Bounce off. Don't give a fuck.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm fucking.
All right, mugs. Well, obviously you're awesome and going through this shit again. Whatever is happening to you. But other than that, how was your week, dude? What did you do?
Worked all week. Fucking trying to ignore stupid ass people. When somebody you're gonna laugh. You're gonna laugh.
Yeah.
I was gonna say, when somebody texts you,
fuck you.
And then they look and they don't respond for hours and hours, and maybe a day or two, but they look at your stories. Does that annoy you?
Yes, it does. Very much so. Very much so, yeah. Jonathan Beermug Cantro. Very much so.
I'll never do that again. Know how it feels.
You know how it feels. But it's, why does it bother you that someone is not texting you back? Like, isn't that the hint?
I guess.
Oh, Muggs, well, it's, you need to do something to fix your life.
I'm sick of fucking people. I'm just sick of fucking people. I'm sick of people telling me what the fuck that, like, I mean, not, outside of this, but, like, unsolicited, like, this is what you need to do, and this is what you need to do, and this is what you need to do. And I'm like, well, shut the fuck up, because you don't know, like, I don't know.
Well, here's what you need to do, Muggs. You need to stop being a bitch.
Yeah.
You're letting things get to you. Don't let it get to you. I mean, things are going to hurt, but it can't affect your day.
Too late for that.
If you just wallow in the misery, then you're never going to get better. Yeah. You're never just going to be happy. You're just going to be all bitchy about something, whether it's a person or a thing or a situation. It's up to you, man. Like Jay-Z said, brush your shoulder off.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Damn, I should be a therapist. I'm starting this new show, Shrinking, and that's what it's kind of about. Like this psychologist or therapist. What they call it, emotional renegade, and he just goes off on people, telling them what to do, like straightforward. It's awesome. Yeah,
I need that guy.
It's really funny. It's a really funny show.
It's weird because I know how to do the right thing. I just don't. And in the fucking crazy part, here's the annoying part. Like I'm only going to reach out so much, right? You know? I'm only going to reach out so much because at that point it's just like, okay, you know, don't chase shit. And don't. The minute that I fucking stop reaching out, it's like they reach out or some shit. Like, what the fuck are they, you know? Like, what the hell is that about?
At that point, shouldn't you be like, hey, fuck you. I'm out.
Yeah.
Muggs, I'm going to be tough on you, man.
You have to be, man. You have to be. I'm just fucking... If anything, I'm most upset at myself. Really. Not, like, disgusted with myself.
It doesn't seem like it, because you keep letting it happen.
I know, and That's the problem. Like, I keep letting it happen. It's like, when the fuck are you going to learn? You know?
That's on you, buddy. Learn. If you burn yourself on something, you can keep touching it? Nope. Right?
Yeah, I mean...
Just be a dick. Start tomorrow. Starting tomorrow, dick muggos. Well, Muggs, even though you're... thing is shitty and your situation is shitty and boring. I actually learned something new this week. Something in my 45 years of life that I did not know about. Did you know water expires?
I knew it.
Well, growing up all my life growing up, there was like people said, make sure you have earthquake supplies. You have water and blankets and shoes and everything. So if you need to, you could survive on it. So during the pandemic, we stocked up on water because, you know, who knew what was going to happen. And got a shit ton of it. You know, like we got Smart Waters, Avion, anything, any kind of water that was left. We got it. We got the gallons, everything. And then the other day, I was on a hike with a buddy. And we're talking about water for some reason. And I told him, yeah, you know, the earthquake preparedness kit, we have a bunch of water. And he's like, how old is it? And I was like, I don't know, like 2 years old. And he tells me, you know, you can't drink that anymore. I was like, what are you talking about? And he goes, yeah, it's expired. I was like, water doesn't expire. It's fucking water. But nope, came home. Looked at the labels. Sure enough, it has the date when the water was filled, and then it has an expiration date, and it lasts about 2 to 3 years depending on the bottle. So I had to dump all that water. Well, I used it for my plants, but it's, I couldn't drink it anymore. And now I have to replace it because it's expired. And it's not that the water's bad or anything. You know why it gets expired, Muggs?
Yeah.
No.
Did you try it?
It's because of the plastic. The plastic starts breaking down and going into the water. And then you can get sick from drinking all that water.
Water.
I mean, if it's the end of the world, we're fucking drinking that water for sure. But right now, nope. Mm-mm. Mm-mm. And you could get some serious disease from drinking that old ass water in the plastic. So my recommended Jenks is if you're going to have that water storage, just get like a bin or something that, that like the preppers yeah. have. Because then no plastic. It's like aluminum or glass or something. Then your water's clean forever. So there you go. Something I learned that I wanted to share with you. And since Muggs is now a dick, he will never learn anything.
I don't give a fuck about your water.
Janky town. Jack. Hit the ground. Jack. We can get the janky popping. That's a sound. Jack, Jack. We make your frown. Jack. Go upside down. Jack. It's getting janky. We the greatest pound for pound. What up, Muggs? Jack. What up, Dave? Jack. What up, bro? Jack. What up, Janks? What up, Muggs? Jack. What up, Dave? Jack. What up, bro? Jack. What up, Janks? It's getting janky. It's getting janky. It's getting janky. I love it when we jank around. It's getting janky. It's getting janky. It's getting janky. I love it when we jank around. Janky! Town.
Yeah, episode 122. Many ways to get a hold of us. Don't get a hold of me because I don't care anymore. And
you gotta be nice to the Jankses, dude.
Not gonna be nice. No, I'll be nice to our Janksters. Of course, no. That they always will receive my kindness. But everybody else can fucking suck a dick. I don't care what you think. I don't care anymore. Many ways to get a hold of us, Dave. Social media, at JankyTown69. The Jank Line, 855-Janky69. And JankyTown@gmail.com. JankyTown69@gmail.com.
That is right. Even though we are at our limit for our storage space for Google, keep emailing. It's fine. I'll just delete shit. It doesn't matter. Because you know why, Muggs? We don't give a fuck, right? All right, Muggs, let's talk about it.
I don't give a fuck about the intro. No, I'm kidding. Let's talk about it, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things that may be. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about it.
Look at that. The I don't give a fuck attitude. Let's talk about it intro. Thanks, Muggs. Well, this past weekend, and the reason why we couldn't record, because both you and I had to work in some capacity on the Super Bowl. So obviously we couldn't get together, and then we were busy both weeks. So Muggs, we didn't have a chance to talk about it. So let's talk about the damn Super Bowl. What did you think, man? What did you think of the outcome? Talk to me, man. What did you think about the game itself?
Great game.
Who were you rooting for?
Well, my money was on the Chiefs, so.
Yeah, that was going to be my next question was, did you gamble on the game?
Yes. I did. And I made money.
What did you gamble?
I put 200 on the Chiefs.
But just the money line?
No, I got them by plus one. Plus one is how I took them.
You took the Chiefs plus one, so basically it was a pick 'em.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was rooting for the Chiefs because I just, like, God, I love Ralph Garman, but I just can't root for the Eagles because of their fans. Their fans are some of the worst fans in the NFL.
Yeah.
I don't know if you were able to see the pregame stuff.
Uh-uh.
So they're announcing the Walter Payton Man of the Year Award, right? And this is something where a player is recognized and for doing stuff for the community, for helping people out, you know, it's all It's all about being a good person. And the winner this year, because every team nominates a player from their team, the winner this year was Dak Prescott from the Dallas Cowboys. Now, the Cowboys and the Eagles are obviously rivals.
Right.
And in the same division. So they're announcing, they're talking about all the good things that Dak has done this year for the community, you know, for charities and everything. So they're like, in the 2013 or 23 Walter Payton Award, 22 Walter Payton Award is Dak Prescott of the Dallas Cowboys. And all you hear is, boo, boo, rain of boos coming down, all from the Eagles fans. And you could see him laughing because he is like, he knew. He knew it was going to happen. But can't they just fucking applaud one time for a rival when he's doing something good? Has nothing to do with the damn Eagles or the actual football game. And they couldn't even applaud then.
Yeah.
You need to be like that, Muggs. Just be fucking petty.
Yeah, man.
Petty as fuck.
I'm telling you. It's the second month of the year. It's not too late, man. You're petty as fuck.
You were watching it at a casino, right?
Yeah, I was at Morongo hosting, so...
Did they have the national anthem there?
Yeah.
What did you think of Chris Stapleton's national anthem?
It's pretty good. He did a pretty good job, I think.
I don't like country music, and I don't know who Chris Stapleton really is, but I thought he did a really good job with it. Like, it felt... Like, the way he sang it, it felt, like, somber and sad. I don't know if it was great for the Super Bowl when you're trying to fire everyone up.
Right.
You know, like, when Whitney Houston's singing it, you're pumped because she's hitting that he's holding that note and fucking hitting it. Yeah. He was just, like, low-key, but it sounded great. And I was like, wow, I feel it, man. I feel this. But I thought he did a really good job. I don't think I'll listen to any of his other music. But he did a good job with this. Here's what I found funny. They made a big deal to announce Troy Kotsur, the actor from CODA, that he's going to do the sign language for it. Who was he doing the sign language for? The people in the arena? Because they did not show him at all during the national anthem.
Maybe.
I found funny.
Yeah, I don't know. It's not for the people.
But don't you think, like, if people were deaf and watching the game on TV, like, they don't know what's going on, and that's right. that's what the ASL signer is for, right?
Yeah.
I don't know. I just found that funny. But the first quarter was just like crazy. Jalen Hurts went off. Patrick Mahomes went off. It was such a good first quarter. Second quarter, same thing, going back and forth. Some great plays. Jalen Hurts fumbles. It's going nuts. And then it's time. It's time for the return of Rihanna. What did you think, Muggs, of the halftime show?
Did not watch one part of the halftime show. I was on the parking structure smoking a joint. So that was my halftime show. So I can't speak on it.
Wow, you just didn't, like, did they play it in the casino?
Yeah.
Nothing?
Yeah, no, they played it, but I was out. I was outside the whole fucking time. I really couldn't care.
So you had no interest in Rihanna?
Not really.
No. Did you see, like, any of it after, though?
Clips. Clips.
Yeah. All right, and then second half, Chiefs make their comeback.
What'd you
think
of Rihanna?
Final play of the game, or, you know, the final...
Wait, hold on, Dave. What'd you think of Rihanna?
Me? I gave her a 7 out of 10 performance. Wasn't the best, wasn't the worst. It was fine. The stage production was fantastic. Dancers, fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
Song selection was fantastic. Her performance was meh. It was okay. I mean, it was fine. First performance in 7 years, and it's like, wow, we missed her. No, I mean, I don't know. But I guess if you say bad things about it, then people hate you, so.
Right.
I just thought it was fine.
I didn't even see it, and I feel that way.
Yeah, but that holding call, the mugs.
You saw that. I didn't see that, no. I didn't see that.
Did you watch the fucking game?
I did, man, but there's so much shit going on in that casino, man. There's people coming up and talking to me. So I must have missed it. But explain what happened.
It was 3rd and 2 or something like that. Mm-hmm. And Patrick Mahomes throws a pass into the end zone. The defender holds Juju Smith-Schuster. And they call defensive holding. And that essentially gave the Chiefs the first down. And then they just kneeled it down until it was time to kick the game-winning field goal. And boom, that was it. But a lot of people were bitching. Like a lot of sportscasters, old athletes, everyone was saying that it was that's not the time to call a holding, even though it was a blatant hold.
It was on the Eagles.
Yeah, yeah, it was 3rd and 2, so it gave them a first down, and it gave them literally the game. Like that was it. You know, there was like about a minute left, so if they let it go and it's incomplete, the Eagles, you know, the Chiefs kick the field goal, and then they have to kick off to the Eagles. Instead, they kicked the field goal, and they had like 4 seconds left. I mean, the holding call was called. The DB admitted that he held him, but people were still bitching about, oh, it was they shouldn't have called it. The refs decided the game. Of course, Twitter blows up, but like, oh, the refs making it about themselves. And I'm just thinking, motherfuckers, this is why no one wants to be a referee. Even when they make the correct call, people are hating them on it. The fucking DB admitted that he held the guy. Held him. He goes, yep, I tugged his jersey.
Right.
Held him. And they're like, oh, well, the ball wasn't catchable. Doesn't matter. He held him.
And this?
Yes. They're like, oh, what a shitty way to end a brilliant game. The refs have to make it about them. They weren't calling shit the whole game, but they call that one. It's like, no, they made the right call. He held him so he can't get to his spot. And the same people who are bitching about, you know, Lord, they were let him play, are the same people that were bitching about the Rams' no call against the Saints. Mm-hmm. Remember that?
Yeah, I remember that.
That sent the Rams to the Super Bowl.
Yeah,
that was clearly pass interference, which should have been called. But no, they didn't call it. And look what happened. Everyone's bitching about him. What terrible officiating. Yes, it was. But you can't have it both ways. It was so annoying just to, like, deal with that and hear that, like, for a couple of days. People bitching, oh, you can't, you know, you have to make the call. You have to let it go. You let them play. Like, sure. I mean, and then what happens if they let it go? The Chiefs kick it, and then the Eagles come down and win on a blown call. Then they're going to be like, they should have called it.
Right?
Right? I don't know, man. People can never be happy with the fucking just let it play out. It was fine. That's the way it ends. That's the way it ends. It's not a fucking TV show with built-in drama. The drama's already there. We don't need it.
Yeah. What did you think of the commercials?
Did you see any?
Yeah, I saw pretty much all of them, I think.
Did they have the audio on in the commercials, or did you guys play music during the...
No, everything, the game from beginning to end was all on the speakers.
Did you like any of the commercials? Did you like?
I thought the Tubi one was funny. The one that made you think that someone was changing the channel. There was actually people in the casino going, hey, whoa, hey.
Really?
Yeah, I knew. We're
fucking idiots.
I know. I knew it was a joke.
What idiots? Like, I know a lot of people were thinking that, like, oh, who? I legit thought I was changing the channel. No, you weren't, you fucking idiot, because your TV doesn't even do that. Like, really? Like, oh, someone's changing it to Mr. and Mr. Smith, Mr. and Mrs. Smith right now?
Somebody in the back of the casino? Yeah. I know. I knew it was fake right away, but I thought that was clever.
It was rated one of the worst commercials.
It was?
Of the time, yeah.
Why?
Yeah. I don't know, because it was a bad commercial, because it went to Mr. and Mrs. Smith. That's why. I don't know, but
funny.
I thought that commercial was dumb. I was like, yeah, whatever. All right, Tubi. No one's fucking going to Tubi. Yeah, but is there one that stood out in your mind?
Other than that, no, that was the only one.
That was I thought the Pepsi ones were pretty fucking stupid.
I didn't see Pepsi. Those.
There's the one, great acting or great tasting?
Oh.
No, neither. Dumb. This is dumb. But the one I did like, what made me like chuckle a little bit, was the HR one. It's like, hey, you're a rock star. And all the rock stars were like, stop calling them rock stars. They're not rock stars. We are. So, like, then Paul Stanley would break into a boardroom when they're like, I was about to say it. Nope, you weren't. Nope, you weren't.
I didn't see that one.
That one's pretty funny. That one's pretty funny. Well, that's, that was the Super Bowl. Overall, man, great Super Bowl. So happy for the Chiefs. Eagles, man, Jalen Hurts. Oof, that dude was a stud that day. I thought he was going to win MVP for a losing team. His defense let him down.
Wait, does the losing team get MVP?
No, not necessarily. He was playing that good that, you know, in basketball, I think... No, they didn't. But, like, I remember LeBron, when he lost against the Warriors, they were saying, like, he was playing so good that he might win the MVP, even though he wasn't on the winning side. And I know it's happened in baseball a couple of times, too, where in the World Series, the MVPs were on the losing team. So, and it hadn't happened since, like, 1972 or something, where a losing player was MVP of the game. But that was before, like, fan voting and all that shit and them going to Disneyland and making commercials and winning a truck and
right.
All that bullshit. But, Muggs, you know what else happened this weekend? The UFC.
Yeah.
The UFC 284 happened in Australia. Now, I forgot who was fighting. It was Volkanovski and someone else. I'm bringing it up because have you ever heard of Tyson Pedro?
No.
Neither have I. He lost. He lost this weekend, and he had a nice excuse for why he lost. And I'll let him explain.
Okay.
I'll let him explain.
Hey, what's going on? Just thought I'd do this video now that the dust has settled. Well, I wasn't actually going to do this video because I didn't think I owed anyone an explanation except the people that I love. But those people that I love have been getting a bit upset about some of the messages because the people don't know maybe what had happened. And I'm not going to lie, some of the messages have been getting to me, but as is the way of social media. First of all and foremost, I wanted to thank Modestos, game opponent. He took the fight on short notice and came out on top. I'm not taking anything away from him, and I think that some people may have thought that's what I was doing by saying that I had health concerns, but that's not the case at all. He came, he beat me, and that's the fight game. But the night before my fight, I contracted gastro. It was extreme diarrhea and vomiting for the whole night. When the bus, UFC bus came, I was still on the toilet ground vomiting, and if you want to confirm it, you can ask the USADA guy who had to sit there watching me shit non-stop for, while he was trying to take my piss test. So I still decided to fight for a couple of reasons, because one, the UFC had sorted out this fight on late notice, so I didn't want to let them down. Two, Modestos had taken the fight on a week's notice, so I didn't want to let him down. Three, because I didn't want to let my daughter down when you say you're going to do something, get in there and do it. And four, I didn't want to let the fans down because I know a lot of them have traveled far to come see me and watch me fight. But there was a lot of people that have been commenting some terrible stuff, and I just don't think that they would have done the same.
Couple of things here. One, he was shitting nonstop and vomiting before the fight.
Nice.
No wonder why. How are you supposed to have energy after that?
Yeah.
But I guess the real problem, too, is this is a fighter I've never heard of. You've never heard of. He wasn't on the main card. And yet, somehow, people are talking shit to this guy on the comments. Why? Why are people bad?
I don't know, dude. People are fucking armchair quarterbacks and they think they're experts at everything. People think they know it all, especially when it comes to professional athletes.
But it's wild to me that someone would someone on the undercard, you're going to leave a comment on, you're going to go to his Instagram and be like, you fucking suck. This is, I'm glad you lost. What the fuck, man? What people the fuck? Oh, well, that was happening. So that was UFC. A couple weeks ago, I went to Bellator, right, at the Forum to see Fedor's last fight. And that was cool. I haven't been to an MMA fight in a minute. So it was cool to see Fedor get his ass kicked right fast by Ryan Bader. But that's not what I'm going to talk about. I went to the vending area, right? I wanted to get some food at the Forum. And they have the Amazon Go style where you just put in a credit card, you go grab what you want, and you bounce out and they send you the receipt, right? Everyone's been in those by now, right? Like everyone's gone through that. But that's not what I want to talk about. I was with my nephew and he wanted a soda. So we go get a Diet Coke. And what the fuck do I see on a shelf? Is Starry.
Oh, yeah.
Muggs, do you know what Starry is?
It's the new Sprite, right?
Sort of. Pepsi makes Starry. And of course, as I said earlier, Pepsi fucking sucks.
Right.
Starry just replaced Sierra Mist.
Huh.
Did you like Sierra Mist, Muggs?
Yeah, I would drink it.
Yeah, it's nice in a can, right? It's refreshing.
Yeah, I would drink
it. But did you know that Sierra Mist replaced Slice?
That I knew.
I did not know that.
I knew that.
You knew that.
Yeah.
But I forgot about Slice until I read this article.
Yeah, I remember Slice. Orange Slice.
But you know why they changed Sierra Mist? Because of Gen Z.
Because
they are targeting Gen Z right now.
Starry?
Pepsi is. With Starry. And there was a taste test done on this Washington Post article. And they said that Starry tasted exactly the same as Sierra Mist. But except it's marketing. And they have a tagline for Starry. For the Gen Z people. And the tagline is, it just hits different. Fucking Starry. God.
That's dumb.
Yeah. Muggsy, you going to the movies?
Last movie I went to was The Menu.
Did you pay for it or was it a screening?
Paid for it on a date.
On a date. All right. Well, now, did you go to AMC?
No, I went to Regal.
Regal. Well, Regal is going bankrupt, so you may go to AMC soon.
Nice.
AMC has introduced this new way of paying for movie tickets. Now, movie tickets that are going to be like the seats that are in the middle, the best viewing area, are going to cost more than the rest of the seats. So it's going to be a tier system on movie tickets now.
When does that take effect?
What do you think about that, Muggs?
That's stupid. But when does that take effect?
It shouldn't be taking effect pretty soon. I think in March.
Maybe I understand why they're doing it. Maybe to make more money. But I think it's in the long run is just going to kill them even more. You know,
it's definitely a pandemic move because they're trying to recoup money. But I don't know if I have a problem with it, Muggs.
I do not agree.
Before it was first come, first serve, right? And fuck that. So then it was, you choose your seat and you just, you know, sign seating. You choose your seat, you buy it. That's the way I thought it was great. But now, why not charge a little more for the middle, right? Like, mm-hmm. why not? It's the best viewing area, like anywhere else. It's all about paying a little extra to guarantee that best viewing area. I don't see a problem with it.
I don't know. We'll see how it works. I don't think it's going to work.
Yeah. But the good thing about it for me, and this is probably why I don't care for it at all, is that people who are members of the Stub Club, the AMC A-listers, the A-plus, or whatever the fuck it's called, they're not going to get charged. It's since you're already paying for the monthly subscription, you get to choose the seats with no additional cost. So just join the club. Have you ever thought about joining that club, Muggs? It's so cool.
The AMC club?
3 movies a week. The AMC A-list club or A Stubbs A-list or something like that.
No, I've never thought about it, but it sounds pretty cool.
It's $24 a month. You get to see 3 movies a week for free.
That's a pretty good deal. It's just by yourself? Deal. You get to bring somebody.
Yeah. No, it's just for you. But you could buy a ticket. And,
right.
I mean, it's on Tuesdays, they're $5 or whatever.
Nice.
But it's great. Muggs, we didn't talk about it last week.
What?
But our boy Kevin, Kev Dog, from the Kevin and Bean Show.
Kevin Ryder.
Formerly from the Kevin and Bean Show. From Kevin's Lego Afternoons on KLOS. Mm-hmm. Homie's engaged.
What?
Popped the question to his very long, 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 long time girlfriend.
Good for him.
Maren Dungy.
Good yeah. for him. I'm glad somebody's in a relationship that works.
Hey.
Oh.
Fuck you.
Sorry.
Dick. But he's engaged. Kev Dog's engaged. But my question is, if he has a wedding ceremony, is Janky Town getting invited?
Nope. Definitely not.
We're still not getting invited, right?
Definitely not.
Do you think anyone from the former show gets invited?
Maybe Omar, the DJ?
Probably. Hey, friend, you're going to come to the wedding, but you're going to go to work. So there's that. That's a good point. But no, man, I don't think they'll even have a ceremony. I think they've both been married before, so they're just going to get married and be like, peace out, suckers.
Yeah.
so don't wait for that invitation.
When are you getting married, Dave?
Look at that. We're out of time. See you later, Jank says. Squish.